Okay, so we've talked about doing some basic data interviewing in spreadsheets, and I want to show you how to do the same thing in R. I'm working in R on my local computer just because it makes it a little bit bigger and easier to see, but this should all work in RStudio Cloud as well. And I'm just going to give myself a document to work in. So I'm going to go to File, New File, R Markdown, and I'm going to call this interviewing. And now I have a blank R Markdown document, which has some of the sort of default stuff in here. So I'm going to take out everything from line 12 down, because I know that's all kind of just generic. And I'm going to put in the packages that we use the most just by using library tidyverse, and then I'll control enter so that I can load the tidyverse. So the first thing that I'm going to need once I get those packages attached is some data to work with. And I want to work with the same data I used in the spreadsheet example. I have it saved as a CSV file, which is what R prefers. And I'm going to show you how to use the import dataset button. It's a little bit better to write code, but I think that with file path issues, the import dataset button is a great start, and then you can use the code that it generates. So click the import dataset button, and then you'd want to select from text read R, so that's the tidyverse package. And then you need to navigate using the browse button to find where your data is stored. Let's see, it's called GSS. Clean, there it is, open, and then it'll give me a little preview of my data set. This might not look that great on my screen because I've got it zoomed in quite a bit. But the idea is to look at the preview data set and make sure that your data looks all right. I'm pretty sure that this one's just going to come in nicely, so I'm going to click the import button. And now it shows up in my environment. And some code prints down in my console. And if I scroll up in the code, I can see it loaded the package read R, and then it ran some code for me. It said GSS clean gets read underscore CSV, parentheses in quotes, GSS clean.csv. So I'm going to copy this, control C, and put this into my R Markdown document, so that I'm keeping everything that I need for my analysis to work in that R Markdown document. So that's how I read in the data. And then I just want to insert another chunk so that I have a place to work to do a little bit more data interviewing. So the first task that we did in the spreadsheets was just sorting a data set. I think we've seen this before, so I'm going to do GSS clean, and then I'm going to do the pipe, the percent greater than percent, or you can do Command-Shift-M, and I'm going to hit enter to put the next piece onto the next line. And if I wanted to just sort my data set, I could use an arrange, and then I need the name of the variable that I want to arrange by. So in this case, I think I wanted to arrange by highest year of school completed, and it's got underscores all the way along. Highest year of school completed. And then I could control enter anywhere on this and it would run it for me. So it's not giving me that much useful stuff in this little tibble that came out, but if I wanted to, I could kind of use this trick of the view function, put a parenthesis, and take off the closing parenthesis, hit enter, and then I can scroll back up through my code to get the last thing that I ran, and then close the other parenthesis of the view around it. And then when I hit enter, it's gonna pop up an arranged version of my data set for me to look at. So this will be arranged by highest year of school completed. And you can see, by default, it orders in ascending order, so we have these people who completed 0 years of school, or 1 year of school, 8 or more children. R is sorting a little bit differently, so the NAs aren't showing up at the top, or maybe that's consistent with Excel. The other way that you can do an arrange in R is just to click on the data set itself, and then all of these have a little up and down arrows, and you can click to sort the data by a particular column. So the nice thing about this is that you don't have to worry about selecting all of the columns. R is always going to respect the row relationship in the data set, so it'll never break the relationship by mixing up the values just of one column. So that's how we could look at the highest year of school completed. And then the thing that we're probably the most interested in is doing a pivot table. So in R, I'm going to insert another R chunk. I'm going to do GSS underscore clean. And then I'm going to think about, with the example that I was doing in the spreadsheet video, I wanted to know the average age for each college major. And so the thing that we're going to do in R is we're going to group underscore by the categorical variable, which in this case was college major. And then I'm going to do another pipe, and I'm going to do a summarize. I think I had sort of skipped over summarize when we were doing data visualization because it's not as relevant to visualization, but summarize is a many-to-one or many-to-few operation. So what I'm going to do is group by college major, which is going to make me almost like little mini data sets for each of the different college majors, and then I'm going to summarize. I want the mean of the age of the person. And let me just verify, it's age of respondent. So I need to get that right, age of respondent. And was it college major? Need to scroll over a little bit. College major underscore one. Sometimes I also go over here and click the little down arrow so that I can see the names of my variables more easily while I'm working. So it was college major underscore one that I was interested in. So now I'm gonna run this data pipeline. Oh, and it gives me a bunch of NAs. That's because there are NAs in the data set. And so the mean of anything that has an NA is going to be NA. So let's throw in a drop NA here. Drop underscore NA. I'm going to drop NAs on age of respondent. So maybe some people didn't want to tell their age. And I'll put another pipe here. And control enter there. Well, it still does not like it. Oh, because age of respondent is not a numeric variable here. This becomes a little bit trickier. So the age of respondent is a character variable with things like 43, 74. In it, and if I went over here and sorted that one, okay, youngest is 18, sort the other way, okay, I've got these things that say 89 or older, so I would have to decide what to do with those in order to turn this variable into something that was numeric. I think I could just turn them into 89s if I wanted to. It's maybe not the smartest thing to do, but it would give me a sort of general idea. So instead of drop NA of age of respondent, I think I'm going to put something else into my pipeline here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mutate, and I'm going to make a new variable called age, and that's going to be equal to parse number of age of respondent. So it's going to make a new variable just called age, and then I'll put the pipe, and then I'm going to just take the mean of the age. So let's see if that works. Ah, now it works. And I can see the same thing, accounting, bookkeeping, 51.4, etc. If I wanted to, I could add another piece into the pipeline to do an arrange. Probably I would want to arrange by the mean age, but I haven't given a name yet, so that's kind of hard to use. So I'm going to go back into my summarize, and I'm going to call this AVG underscore age. And now I could arrange in I think ascending order will be interesting of AVG underscore age Toronto. And so then I can see the youngest, public relations, television, film, etc. And then it's going up. And again, if I wanted to use that view trick, I could view in the console with a parenthesis, and then hit enter, and then hit the up arrow a couple times to get the code, and then close the parenthesis around it. And then this will let me see just kind of like a temporary view in my data viewer. So that's the basic idea of pivot tables in R, is that you're going to use a group by and then a summarize. Let's see if we can find one that's a little bit more simple. So maybe I would want to do the respondents' sex and their labor force status. So I could look at the relationship between those two variables by grouping by both respondents' sex, comma, labor underscore force underscore status, and then another pipe, and summarize n is equal to n open paren close paren. So this is a common summarize operation where you want to just know what's the number in each one of the groups that's going to get passed through. And if I control enter, now I can see the relationship between the person's sex and their labor force status. So there's 204 females keeping house, only 38 males keeping house. There's 226 retired females in this data set, 219 retired males. And if I wanted to have the data arranged, sort of grouped the other way, I could change the order of the grouping. So labor force status, comma, respondent sex. And then if I control enter, now it's going to do the ordering this way. So put keeping house together, so it's maybe easier to make the comparison between the respondents' sex and their labor force status. So again, if someone says, can you do pivot tables? You can say, yes, you can do them in spreadsheets, and then you can do so much more in R.